Hi guys, today I will be reviewing the Comica, let me check how it's pronounced, CVM V30 Lite microphone. That's for both cameras and smartphones. Full disclosure, Comica asked me to review this product for them, and I didn't have to pay for the microphone, but this will still be a completely independent review. So let's first do a quick unboxing. You can see what comes in the package. So now a quick unboxing of the Comica mic. So inside we find a user manual, whatever the hell this is, Amazon seller's card, I think. So this is the microphone itself. Has a screw-on mount for tripods. Also, you can use the hot shoe, and it doesn't take batteries, and that's a big advantage over the Texner that I normally use. And you have a little switch here for turning from camera to your mobile phone, because you can use this microphone with both cameras and phones. So now I have the Comica on the camera. Yeah, you can check the sound for yourself. Let me just maybe read something off the box so you can have an example how it sounds. Yeah, let's read the specifications so you also know them. Polar pattern, super cardioid, frequencies 40 Hz to 20 kHz. Output impedance 2.2 kilo ohm. Max SPL is above 100 decibel. Sensitivity minus 34 to plus 3 decibel. Signal to noise ratio above 68 decibel. Weight 52 grams. Yeah, I can definitely say that. It's very, very lightweight. And dimensions is 160 times 50.8 times 80.6 millimeters. So it's very light, it's not that small, but compared to the Texner that expands a lot in the outside, I think it's a little bit smaller, but bulkier in its height. So I'm outside. I'm at now the bottom of the biggest mountain, it's man-made but still a mountain, in my hometown. Yeah, I chose to go on the mountain because I want to check how well the mic will be able to handle the wind. So I'll see you along the way and then at the top. So I'm still quite far from the top, but the wind is picking up a bit already, so you'll be able to judge how well the mic is handling the wind. It's a very beautiful day. It's still it's late February, but I think it's about 16 degrees today, so it's very full here, but let's see. So I'm now basically still at the bottom of the stairs when I have to go up way up high. So I'm now almost at the top of the mountain, and you can see right here, that's the Tetraeder, it's the monument. I choose to didn't go all the way up, it's just another, I think, 5 meters up. But there are less people here, so I have more quiet environment. Yeah, I hope the mic sounds good outside. So this is now the sound of the internal microphone of the Honor 9 Lite. I will now connect the Comica mic with the phone, and you can also hear what that sounds like. So since the Comica mic doesn't have a screw-on mount for the phone, I have to mount it myself, or you can use an air bracket with it. Yeah, I have no idea how the audio sounds. Maybe I'm too close, maybe I'm too far. You will be the judge of that. So I just realized that before I didn't change the little knob here to phone, so I don't know if it even recorded the sound of the microphone. So this now is the sound of the microphone, and I will now show you the sound without it. This is the internal microphone of the Honor 9 Lite. Yeah, Let's see if now there's a difference or not. Or maybe it works whichever way you put the switch.
So now at the highest point of the mountain, not on the detail itself, but the highest point of the mountain, and the wind is picking up quite a bit, so you'll be able to hear how well the Comica mic is able to handle the heavy winds. You can see my metering is going in the red sometimes, but yeah, I have no idea how it sounds right now, so I have to now get back home and check. So now I start to make my way back down to my car. Let's maybe talk about a bit about the pros and cons of the mic. Obviously I haven't heard how it sounds outdoors yet. Indoors I think the sound is good. It's a bit quieter than the Texter, because the Texter can be boosted up to 10 dB right in camera, on the mic camera. Yeah, but the big advantage really is that it doesn't take a battery like the Texter. So now I look directly in the sun, I can't see anything anymore. So yeah, as I said, the big advantage is that the Comica mic doesn't take a mic. The big advantage of the Comica is that it doesn't take batteries, so you don't have to worry if the battery is still running, so you can just press record and know that the audio is being recorded. Yeah, especially for outdoors and vlogging style, I think it's great. For the price, the competitors are pretty much the Texter SGC598, I think. That will cost you around 30 euros. And the next competitor would be the Rode Video Micro, which is a bit more expensive. I'm not sure if it sounds 20 euros better. So with that, the outdoor part of my review is pretty much completed. I will now go back inside. Check the files, check the sounds, and yeah, then give my final thoughts. If the audio is decent, which I hope, I can fully recommend this microphone. For the price, I think the inner sound was very good. The outer sound is hopefully okay as well. I think for the price, it's really invaluable that it doesn't take batteries. Because how often did I go out with my Texter, forgot to turn on, and ended up having clips with no sound. If you're not an idiot like me, then you can maybe just check also your meter to see if it's recording audio, but I, in the heat of the moment, often forgot to do that. Yeah, so I will continue to use this, especially if the audio is good outside. So my conclusion for the Comica CVM V30 Lite is that I can highly recommend this microphone. I think it's very good. I think the fact that you don't need batteries is awesome, especially when you are doing vlogging. As you heard yourself, it's not that good in heavy winds, but I think that's not really the fault of this microphone in itself, but it's just the problem for shotgun mics. So if you're out in heavy winds, maybe use a lav mic, that should be better. Yeah, you can find this microphone on Amazon. I will leave the link down below. I once again would like to thank Comica for giving this for free to me. I hope you liked the review. I hope you consider subscribing to my channel to maybe see more reviews and other photography videos. So yeah, I'll see you next time. Bye.